We've all heard the name Jamarcus Russell. Some call him the biggest bust in NFL history. That would mean he would have had to been at the top of the game at some point, right? Let's take a look at Jamarcus Russell's story and where it all went wrong. Hit that like and subscribe button, and let's get into it. Jamarcus Russell went to Lily B. Williamson High School, where he started for 4 years and set the Alabama high school passing yards record that still stands today. Coming off a great high school career and standing 6'5", Jamarcus chose to commit to LSU. He redshirted his freshman year and became the full-time starter the year after. Russell improved drastically in his 3 years at LSU, going from 9 to 15 to 28 touchdowns in his final season. He decided to forego his fourth season at LSU and enter the NFL draft. Up until this point, Jamarcus Russell seemed to be the answer to any NFL franchise's QB problem. He was physically dominant and had one of the best arms scouts had ever seen. I mean, come on, the guy could throw 70 yards from one knee. Longtime NFL draft analyst Mel Kiper scouted Russell to be a top 5 QB only 2 to 3 years into his NFL career and said you're looking at a John Elway-like talent. But as we know with the NFL, it is more than just being talented, and the problem started showing early for Russell. The Oakland Raiders were coming off a 2-14 season with Andrew Walter under center. You don't know who that is? He threw for 3 touchdowns and 13 interceptions his rookie season, so you don't need to know who he is. Raiders owner Al Davis selected Jamarcus Russell first overall, despite some kickback from Raiders staff, including head coach Lane Kiffin, who suggested they take Calvin Johnson first overall. The Raiders needed a new QB badly, so at the time, Russell seemed like the correct choice. Remember those problems I alluded to earlier? Well, it didn't take long for Russell and his agents to stir up some drama with the franchise. He held out all of training camp and even week one of the season over a contract dispute. Right before week two, he signed a 6-year deal worth $68 million with $31.5 million guaranteed. Russell made a couple of appearances that year, impressing in none of them, but would get the start in the last game of the season. He threw 2 interceptions and lost a fumble that game, but was immediately named the starter for the 2008 season by Lane Kiffin. This video is brought to you by Sports Betting Dime. If you're trying to find a book to bet on for NFL season or really any sport, they pool all of the major book odds together so you can find the best odds. Go and join that book. They also have reviews from all those bookmakers. Also, if you're not really into sports betting and you want to get into it, they have tips, they have their tricks, they have articles on their website, sportsbettingdime.com, that you guys can check out to learn about the sports betting game and find the book that best suits you. Go check them out, sportsbettingdime.com. Russell's 2008 season was slightly better, but that's not saying much. He did manage to start 15 games, but he only threw 13 touchdowns with 8 interceptions and 12 fumbles. Just his second season in the league, and considering he only played in a handful of games his rookie season, it wasn't the end of the world. Surely the incredibly talented and physically gifted number one overall pick would work hard and improve, right? Well, to be frank, it was the complete opposite. 5 weeks into the 2009 season, Russell was benched for backup QB Bruce Gradkowski. He'd be pretty much buried on the depth chart for the rest of the season, only getting snaps due to injuries. He would finish the 2009 season with the lowest quarterback rating, completion percentage, fewest passing touchdowns, and fewest passing yards among qualifying NFL QBs. 3 seasons into Jamarcus Russell's career, it was already widely known the pick was a disaster, especially since the guy they were considering at number one, Calvin Johnson, had 12 touchdowns his sophomore season. Russell's work ethic was constantly questioned by the media and coaching staff. Even so much so, they gave him a test. The Raiders coaching staff didn't believe he was watching film to prepare, so they sent him home with empty cassettes. The next day, he walked into work and said he had watched blitz packages. Well, that must have been pretty embarrassing, but it gets worse. During the 2010 offseason, NBC Sports reported that Russell was pushing 300 pounds. Even Big Ben was jealous of that number. He was released before the start of the season, and although he had a few workouts around the league, he was never signed again. It's insanely rare to see a number one pick released after 3 years and not even land with another team. He even wrote a letter to all 32 teams saying he'll play for free, but no one took him up on it. Funny how 4 years prior, he was negotiating tooth and nail for more money, missing camp and preseason time, which definitely contributed to his downfall. Russell never had a great surrounding cast, as former head coach Lynn Kiffin has admitted, but it's also true that Jamarcus Russell had one of the worst work ethics of all time. He's currently a QB coach at his old high school, but it makes you think, what could have been for the incredibly talented and physical behemoth that was Jamarcus Russell? If you did enjoy, leave a like, comment your thoughts on Russell's situation below, and if you want to see us do this series on any other players, let us know as well. Any sport. Until next time, peace out, guys.